to learners. How is it going? I hope that everything is going good, well and fine. Welcome to your grammar video lessons. This is Dishita ma'am, and today we are going to start new topic, that is chapter number 19, page number 74, present continuous tense. What is our today's topic? Our today's topic is chapter number 19, present continuous tense. Before we start chapter reading and exercise of chapter, I would like to request you all to please close your textbook and let's have a look on a brief summary of present continuous tense, brief introduction on present continuous tense. Dear kids, you need not have to write anything right now. Please close your textbook, put your pencils down and just look here. And here we go with the learning objective. The learning objective of the topic present continuous tense is, at the end of this lesson, you will be able to identify the continuous form of the present tense. You will also be able to talk about the things happening at the time of speaking. You can use the structure for communication. So dear kids, I hope that you all understand what is the learning objective of this lesson. Alright, but before we learn about present continuous tense, it's time to revise the tenses. It's time to revise what is tense. What is tense, dear kids? The tense of a verb shows that time of an action, shows the time of an action. Tense of a verb, yani verb ka jo tense hota hai, wo hame time of an action batata hai, shows the time of an action. It tells us when an action takes place. It tells us when an action takes place. There are three types of tense. As I told you earlier also, there are three types of tense. What are they? They are present tense, past tense, future tense. What are they? Present tense, past tense, and future tense. Let's see towards the example of it for better understanding. The first example of present tense is Ram plays in the park every day. Ram plays in the park every day. The verb plays is in the present tense. The verb plays is in the present tense, as it tells us that the action is taking place now. As it tells us that the action is taking place now. Alright. Then past tense. Example, Ram played in the park last evening. Ram played in the park last evening. The verb played is in the past tense. The verb played is in the past tense, as it tells us that the action took place in the past. Let's see the last one, future tense. Future tense example is Ram will play in the park tomorrow. Ram will play in the park tomorrow. The verb will play is in future tense. The verb will play is in future tense, as it tells us that the action will take place at some time in the future. As it tells us that the action will take place at some time in the future. Alright, dear kids, The tense of a verb not only shows the time of an action, but also shows the state of the action. That is, it indicates whether the action is complete or incomplete. The tense of a verb not only shows the time of an action, yani tense of a verb, खाली हमें टाइम ऑफ एन एक्शन ही नहीं बट ऑल्सो शोज द स्टेट ऑफ द एक्शन इट ऑल्सो शोज द स्टेट ऑफ द एक्शन दैट इज इट इंडिकेट्स वेदर द एक्शन इज कंप्लीट और इनकम्प्लीट लेट्स लुक एट सम एग्जाम्पल्स टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर एग्जाम्पल Jia goes to the library every day. Jia goes to the library every day. Present regular action. Present regular action. Here goes is in present regular action. It refers to the simple form of the present tense. It refers to the simple form of the present tense. Now, let's see the second one. Jia is going to the library. Jia is going to the library. Is going here is in present incomplete action. Is going here is in present incomplete action. Why? It refers to the continuous form of the present tense. It refers to the continuous form of the present tense. Then, Jia has gone to the library. Here, has gone is in present complete action. Here, has gone is in present complete action as it refers to the present tense in a complete manner, or we can say it refers to the perfect or complete form of the present tense. Alright, let's repeat it one more time. Jia goes to the library every day. It means every day Jia goes to the library. Here it is in, here the goes, verb goes is in present regular action. It is in present regular action as it refers to the simple form of the present tense. As it refers to the simple form of the present tense. Now, Jia is going to the library. Is going is in present incomplete action. Jia is going to the library. वो अभी जा रही है इट रिफर्स टू द कंटिन्यूअस फॉर्म ऑफ द प्रेजेंट टेंस देन जिया हैज गॉन टू द लाइब्रेरी हियर हैज गॉन टेल्स अस दैट इट इज इन प्रेजेंट कंप्लीट एक्शन इट रिफर्स टू द परफेक्ट और कंप्लीट फॉर्म ऑफ द एक्शन कंप्लीट फॉर्म ऑफ द प्रेजेंट टेंस एज द एक्शन कंप्लीटेड ऑलराइट Now, let's move forward and in this lesson, we shall learn about the present continuous tense. So, let's start with present continuous tense. Present continuous tense. The present continuous tense of a verb is used to express an action taking place at the present moment. Or at the time of speaking. Dear kids, the present continuous tense of a verb, किसी भी verb का present continuous tense use होता है to express an action. To express an action taking place at the present moment. Taking place at the present moment. Present moment or at the time of speaking. Alright, let's see the examples. I am going to the market now. मैं मार्केट जा रही हूँ. I am going to the market now. अभी मैं मार्केट जा रही हूँ. The verb am going indicates an action that is taking place now. The verb indicates an action that is taking place now. Then Rita is studying in her room. Rita is studying in her room. Similarly, the verb indicates an action that is taking place now. So, what we had seen that present continuous tense is formed by adding is, are, or am is formed by adding is, are, or am plus verb with the verb with ing form with verb with ing form. See, studying, going. Alright, and with it, what we had written? We had written be form, am, then is, be form of the verb. So, present continuous tense is formed by adding is, are, am, plus verb with ing form, with ing form. Let's move forward and see more about present continuous tense. Let us see the notes. Dear kids, you need not have to write anything. आपको कुछ भी लिखना नहीं है, आपको सिर्फ समझना है what is present continuous tense. This is just and just for your better understanding. I had written it to explain you. Alright. So, present continuous tense is also used to refer to a temporary action that may not be necessarily taking place at the time of speaking. Now here, present continuous tense is also used to refer to a temporary action that may not be necessarily taking place at the time of speaking. इसका मतलब है प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूस टेंस उसके लिए भी यूज होता है जो टेम्पररी एक्शन में नॉट बी नेसेसरली टेकिंग प्लेस एट द टाइम ऑफ स्पीकिंग. ऑलराइट, फॉर एग्जांपल, शी इज वर्किंग एट द बेकरी दिस डेज. दिस डेज शी इज वर्किंग इन अ बेकरी एट द बेकरी. शी इज वर्किंग एट द बेकरी दिस डेज. Then let's see the another example. Nowadays I'm staying with my grandparents. Nowadays I'm staying with my grandparents. The above highlighted verbs refers to temporary actions that may not be necessarily taking place at the time of speaking. जरूरी नहीं है कि जब हम बोले तभी वो हो रहे हो. Few of the verbs are referred to temporary action also that may not be necessarily taking place at the time of speaking. Alright, let's move further and see note number 2. So, dear kids, note number 2 is the present continuous tense may also be used to refer to the definite action that is arranged to take place in the near future. इसका मतलब है, the present continuous tense को हम use कर सकते हैं to refer a definite action that is arranged to take place in the near future. जिसको arrange किया गया है, मतलब जो verb को arrange किया गया है उस तरीके से जो अभी just place लेने वाला है. Okay, the present continuous tense may also be used to refer to a definite action. It's a definite action that is arranged, जिसको arrange किया गया है to take place in the near future. Let's see the example. Ram is going to Delhi tomorrow. कल राम दिल्ली जाने वाला है. राम इज गोइंग टू दिल्ली टुमारो. देन वी आर गोइंग फॉर अ हॉलीडे नेक्स्ट वीक. वी आर गोइंग फॉर अ हॉलीडे नेक्स्ट वीक. नियर फ्यूचर वाले एक्शंस जो डेफिनाइट एक्शन है, जो टेक प्लेस होंगे ही होंगे. ऑलराइट, दे आर ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. द अबव हाईलाइटेड वर्ब्स इंडिकेट्स डेफिनाइट एक्शन, इंडिकेट्स डेफिनाइट एक्शन दैट आर टेकिंग प्लेस इन द नियर फ्यूचर, दैट आर टेकिंग प्लेस इन द नियर फ्यूचर. लेट्स मूव फॉरवर्ड एंड सी नोट नंबर 3. Our next note number 3 is the present continuous tense of a verb is formed by using the simple present tense. हमने simple present tense पढ़ा ना, जिसमें हमने habits, true facts के बारे में पढ़ा था. तो the present continuous tense of a verb is formed by using the simple present tense. किससे form होता है? By using the simple present tense of the helping verb, of the helping verb be, with ing form, of the main verb. Look at the following table. These all are persons. First person, second person, third person. These all are number of grammar, singular, plural, and plural. These all are pronouns, I, we, you, he, she, it, and they. Then, these are the simple present tense verbs with helping verb, be, This is the main verb. Work ka ing form. I had taken the example of work ka ing form. So let's have a look towards it. First person. We are talking about first person. First person singular. Wait, I'll show you the first person. This is the first person. Alright, first person singular. I, first person singular I, pronoun I, with I we use am, am helping verb of be, with I we use helping verb am. Then plural, we, plural means more than one, singular means only one, we, plural. With plural, we use are. With I singular, we use am. So, it becomes I am working. We are working. Then, let's come to second person. Second person singular, you. Second person is you. Both in singular as well as in plural. फर्स्ट पर्सन सिंगुलर होता है आई, सेकेंड पर्सन प्लूरल होता है वी, सॉरी फर्स्ट पर्सन प्लूरल होता है वी, सेकेंड पर्सन सिंगुलर एंड प्लूरल दोनों होता है यू और दोनों के साथ क्या लगता है आर, क्या लगता है आर. एंड थर्ड पर्सन सिंगुलर होता है ही शी इट. थर्ड पर्सन ऑफ ग्रामर सिंगुलर होता है ही शी एंड इट, जिसके साथ लगता है आई एस इज, जिसके साथ लगता है आई एस इज. ही इज वर्किंग, शी इज वर्किंग, इट इज वर्किंग. राइट, देन प्लूरल. तो प्लूरल इज दे, थर्ड पर्सन प्लूरल इज दे, टी एच ई वाई दे, जिसके साथ लगेगा आर. दे आर वर्किंग, दे आर वर्किंग. So dear kids, now let us have a look of all of these examples. I am working. I am working. We are working. We are working. You are working. You are working. He is working. She is working. It is working. They are working. Likewise, instead of saying working, you can also say playing, dancing, reading, studying, watching, any of the verb you can take. Alright, so what do we have learned? What we had learned? We had learned the first thing, that is the tense of a verb shows that the time of an action, the tense of verb shows the time of an action. It tells us when an action takes place. It tells us when an action takes place. This is the first point which we had seen now. Then the second thing which we had seen is the tense of verb. The tense of a verb not only shows the time of an action but also shows the state of the action. That is, it indicates whether the action is complete or incomplete. Right? The tense of verb not only shows the time of an action but also shows the state of the action. That is, it is indicate, that is, it indicates whether the action is complete or incomplete. Then there are three main tenses we had seen. And what are they? Present tense, past tense, future tense. Out of which tense we had learned today? We had learned the present continuous tense. प्रेजेंट टेंस की एक कैटेगरी होती है सिंपल प्रेजेंट टेंस, दूसरी कैटेगरी होती है प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. तो हमने कौन सी टेंस पढ़ा अभी? प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. देन द फोर्थ पॉइंट विच वी हैड लर्न टुडे इज द टेंस ऑफ अ वर्ब विच डिस्क्राइब एन इनकम्प्लीट और कंटिन्यूअस एक्शन इज कॉल्ड द कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. The tense of a verb which describes an incomplete or continuous action is called the continuous tense. Then, the present continuous tense of a verb is used to express an action. Fifth point we had seen is the present continuous tense of a verb is used to express an action taking place at the present moment or at the time of speaking. Alright, the present continuous tense of a verb is used to express an action taking place at the present moment or at the time of speaking. Then, sixth point which we had learned today is the present continuous tense is also used to refer to a temporary action. Present continuous tense is also used to refer to a temporary action that may not be necessarily taking place. That may not be necessarily taking place at the time of speaking. हमने देखा ना अभी present continuous tense is also used to refer to a temporary action that may not be necessarily taking place at the time of speaking. Then the next point which we had seen just now is the present continuous tense may also be used to refer to a definite action that is arranged to take place in the near future. जिसमें हमने देखा Ram is going to Delhi tomorrow. Example हमने देखा ना, The present continuous tense may also be used to refer to a definite action that is arranged to take place in a near future. In the near future. Then, just now we had seen the present continuous tense of a verb is formed by using the simple present tense of the helping verb be with ing form of the main verb. The present continuous tense of a verb is formed by using simple present tense of a verb of a helping verb be with ing form, with ing form of the main verb. So this is what the introduction of the present continuous tense. It is a small introduction on present continuous tense. Now it's time to open your textbook. अब आप सब अपनी textbook open करो. Let us read the textbook content and do the textbook basic exercise. Open page number 74 and let us read this sentences. Mrs. Mathur drive to work every day. Mrs. Mathur drive to work every day. Today she is going by the metro train. Today she is going by the metro train. The present continuous tense tells us about the action that is happening now. As I told you that the present continuous tense tells us about the action happening now. Then it uses the auxiliary verb. It uses the auxiliary verb is, auxiliary verb am, auxiliary verb are, auxiliary verb are, plus the ing form of the verb. These are also known as be verbs. These are also known as be verb, or we can say auxiliary verb. So the present continuous tense tells us about the action that is happening now. Present continuous tense tells us about the action that is happening now. It uses the auxiliary verb is, am, are plus the ing form of the verb. Which of the two sentences above is in present continuous form? Yes. Today she is going by the metro train. Today she is going by the metro train. This is in present continuous form. And everyday wala is in which form? Simple present tense. Very good. Now come to the first exercise, that is tick the correct option. We have to tick the correct option with the auxiliary verbs. Okay, auxiliary verb mein humko tick karna hai. They had given us two forms, whether is or are will come, whether am or is will come, whether are or is will come, or whether is or are will come. So let us read the sentences and then let's decide ki kaun si cheez kahan par aayegi. Tick the correct option wale session pe aajao, page number 74 pe. And let's start the first exercise, that is tick the correct option. And the question is, the girl dash skipping with a rope. A girl is only one here, singular. So what we will write? We will write is. So we are going to tick is. Tick is. The girl is skipping with a rope. If there is girls, more than one. So we may tick are. But here we are talking about only one girl. So we will tick is. Then I dash helping my mother bake a cake. What will come? I am helping my mother bake a cake. I am helping my mother to bake a cake. Okay. Then, or I am helping my mother in baking a cake. Okay, there is a minor mistake. I am helping my mother in baking a cake. Alright, now let's see the next one. The stars are or is looking brighter today. Stars, it means we are talking about more than one, plural, stars. See, stars. So what will come? Are or is? Are. Very good. The stars are looking brighter today. Now come to page number 75. In page number 75, see, Tina is or are making a sandcastle with her friend. What we will write? Tina is. Very good. Tina is making a sandcastle with her friend. Then come to the last one. John and Susie dash watching a cartoon show. What will come? John and Susie are watching cartoon show. Is nahi aega. Why? Because we are talking about more than one. John and Susie are watching a cartoon show. So dear kids, that's all for today. See you tomorrow with a new concept of ing form of page number 75. Till then, bye, take care, thank you and namaskar.